Hey guys, Chad Lyman here, Extreme Couture in Vegas. Funker Tactical, Aperture Fight Focused. I'm with Eli Knight, BJJ Black Belt. Close friend of mine from just online. We've begun to interact and share a lot of ideas. I just saw you roll with Mike Pyle. Mike Pyle, UFC veteran. Look for a technique video that's gonna go up soon that they taped while Mike was here. You guys were rolling at a pace that a lot of guys would watch it and go, that's not really fighting.
Yeah.
Why are you going at the pace you're going? And a lot of guys have that question.
Oh man, that's the learning pace. You know, I mean, to feel the intricacies of the movement, to really isolate things so that like the details are you don't rush past it, you know? So like if when you're going hardcore, sometimes you're not gonna remember things that happened 3 moves back. I always tell people like if you can't remember how the finish was set up 3, 5, 10 moves back, then you're going too hard, you know? And it's good, you know, you gotta max out, you gotta go hard sometimes, but every time you go into the gym, you don't put all the weight you can on the bar, you know? So you go at a learning pace, you go at a learning speed. To me, that's the most constructive thing.
So one way that I conceptualize this for my athletes, because I get to coach a lot of guys who either fight in a street setting in law enforcement or military, or they compete competitively in MMA or Brazilian Jiu Jitsu. And one way I conceptualize this for guys is I compare it to teaching a child to drive a car.
Yeah.
So if you think back, have you ever had that experience?
Yeah.
Dude, I have 8 kids.
Yeah.
So a lot of my kids drive, some of them are still too young.
Yeah.
But I've taught a child to drive multiple times.
Did you take them on the freeway first thing?
No, but that's how it is. These guys come into the gym and they go, coach, when do I get to drive on the freeway? And when we teach our kid to drive, we don't go to the on-ramp and switch seats and then he takes off. Because then the whole experience would be crap, crash.
Yeah.
So instead, we take him to that empty parking lot, probably a church parking lot during the week, no one's there. And we teach him to drive in the parking lot. Once they master driving in the parking lot, where do we go? Neighborhood street,
yeah.
Right? Once the neighborhood streets are good, where do we go?
Yeah.
Main thoroughfares. And finally, we're gonna drive on the freeway.
Yeah.
We get value at every stage there. Now, you're a black belt. How many years training?
About 22.
How many years coaching?
Coaching about 18, 19.
Today, I saw you on neighborhood streets driving.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was
sure.
That neighborhood street pace.
Yeah. Yeah.
But that's still, you're still doing that today, years later.
Oh, absolutely. Well, I mean, Mike is such an elite athlete, too. And his jiu-jitsu, his grappling, everything is much higher than mine. And so if I'm gonna pick up anything from him, and we actually get to exchange whenever we go at that pace too, because he's stopping me and asking me what I was doing in places. I'm trying to pick his brain, and we can't do that if we're just going boom, boom, just kind of run each other over, man. He's gonna do that to me every time.
Now here's the key though. This is a disconnect I found in law enforcement military training. This is why I started training outside my department, was my department didn't have the movement. They didn't have a pace. It was step, 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 I'm gonna throw a punch, our feet aren't moving, there's no pressure, no exchange, right?
Yeah.
So even when I'm in that parking lot or I'm on that neighborhood street, there's an exchange.
Yeah.
And then all I do is I master that, is I just change tempo.
Yeah, yeah.
But the movements are the same, the principles, the concepts are the same. For all you guys out there training and or coaching, remember, you've gotta understand how to drive pace, but we've gotta have the car moving. If I took my kid outside and said, we're gonna learn to drive and I didn't start the car,
right.
Oh, step on the gas, step on the brake, turn. They didn't learn to drive.
But you take that written test before, right?
Yep.
So you take that written, that permit test, you get all that. So yeah, there's the opposite extreme of that too. There's going in and only crashing and smashing into each other. And if you can sustain that and not just be completely wrecked and injured, you probably are gonna excel, you are gonna get better, but you're gonna have to go the hardest way about it the whole time, you know? Or you can go the opposite extreme and just kind of talk and theorize and only go staccato, step by step. And so, yeah, it takes a mixture, right? I mean, absolutely.
Yep. So sometimes we're going hard, sometimes we're going easy. Even I still get back in the parking lot. Black belt, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, not the greatest guy in the world, pretty good coach though. I still get back in that parking lot, I still get back on those neighborhood streets, and sometimes I let it open and I get out on the freeway. Tonight, you're gonna see a lot of that driving speed. We're gonna stay off the freeway. All right, brother. Go train.